if you know me, you know that I'm not really a salesy kind of person, but I'm going to get a little salesy with these because I'm pretty excited about this. I've waited a long time to unveil these to you, and now's the perfect time because you're going to be able to get your own. This is MONTEK X2000. Solar generator, power station, whatever you want to call it. It holds 2,072 watt hours of power, which is good. But here's where it gets great. This is the MONTEK B2000. It also holds 2,072 watt hours of power. But this can either be used as an external battery connected to the X2000, or it can run completely independently on its own as a standalone unit. I think I can pretty safely say that there's nothing else quite like that on the market, so let's take a look.
Maximalist minibus with Mary and Captain and you. Get on the bus!
You may have seen my MONTEK X1000s before. They're these James Bondy looking kind of suitcase power stations. I've been using them to power my bus for the past 3 years. And I love my MONTEK X1000s, don't get me wrong, but this next version, this is a whole new ballgame in so many ways. They have the same look to them, but they have more capacity, a more powerful inverter, and all kinds of other features. This sturdy case and the caps over the inputs and doors that cover all the outputs make this very water resistant when everything's closed up. In this door on this side, you have your AC inputs. That is 110 volt power. That's where you plug in standard household type things. And then on this side, you've got the input for AC charging, your DC inputs, you know, cigarette lighter port, some 5521 ports, those little, you know, 12 volt barrel plugs that you use for lighting and things like that. And then there's all different kinds of USB ports. When you're using the unit, you need to leave both of those doors open, even if you're only using one set of inputs, because there's a fan in there and you need to keep both doors open for the airflow. That's what keeps the battery cool. Here's the display on the X2000. It shows you a lot of great information, but I'm going to go over the information that is on it once I have them set up in the bus, because out here you can't see that well. And anyway, I don't have any power coming in or going out, so there's not as much to show you. This on the front, this is where the solar plugs in, and you can use just about any solar panel with these. You can use portable ones, or I have panels on the roof, but the X2000 can take up to 850 watts, 150 volts of solar. This here, this is where you connect the B2000. When you connect them together, the X2000 and the B2000 essentially pool their capacity. So with one added, the capacity increases to 4,144 watt hours. You can add another and another, up to three. So you could make this a maximum 8,288 watt hour system. And I only have one add-on here, but you get the point. The B2000 has its own solar input up to 600 watts and its own output. What it does not have is an inverter, so you can't plug 110 volt things into it, and it doesn't have a cigarette lighter plug. Those are not in there just to make it smaller and a little bit lighter, but you can use an adapter from 5521 to cigarette lighter port to create one. I'm going to be using both of them together. So now I have them set up inside the bus so I can show you the display. On the left, you see how much power is coming in and from what source, which in this case, it's solar. But keep in mind that you can also charge them from your vehicle's cigarette lighter plug or from the wall. I did that when they arrived. They came in the box about 30% charged, and I brought them up to full from AC power at my friend's house plugged in so that I'd just be refilling them with solar because it's a little bit faster with AC. I have the solar plugged in to only the X2000 right now, and it's actually the X2000 that is charging the B2000. So whichever one has more juice is going to keep the other one topped off so they stay about even. The input time, which is right above, shows how long it takes to get to full. And below the battery image is the percentage of charge. Below that is the temperature of the battery, which is just about the same as the ambient temperature here right now. You can see up in this corner that the fan is on, which the fan is using 1 watt of DC power. And on AC is the fridge. The fridge compressor is running right now. There are lots of settings that you can customize to whatever's going to be best for you. For example, you can set it to turn the inverter off automatically if no charge is detected on the AC side for a certain period of time, which, you know, if you're running an AC fridge like I am, I don't want it to turn the fridge off, so I set that to never turn it off. But if you're mostly running 12 volt stuff, you might want to do that to save power. I'm not going to get super technical with this review because there are people out there who do that part a lot better than me, namely Hobotech. He has a review out of these right now that you should look for. But I should tell you that the 2000 series are not the only new thing that MONTEK is putting out. There's also the X1200 and the B1200. And the difference is, well, the amount of power is different. The 2000 has 2072 watt hours. The 1200 has 1280 watt hours. But there's another big difference, which is the battery chemistry. The 2000s have NMC pouch batteries. NMC is the standard for smaller lithium batteries, like the ones you get in your cell phone and things like that. And they're also very frequently used for solar as well. But the X1200 and B1200 have LFP batteries, which for a lot of people, that's the preferred battery chemistry right now for solar. These batteries, the ones in the 2000 series, are rated for 1500 cycles to 80%. That means that every time a battery goes from 100% full to completely empty, that's a cycle. So you can do that 1500 times with these batteries. And then after that point, the batteries are still able to hold about 80% of the original capacity. So instead of roughly 2000 watt hours, after you've cycled them 1500 times, you're gonna have like 1800 watt hours available every time you charge it. Now, the ones in the 1200s, the LFP units, they get 2,500 cycles before they drop to 80%. So theoretically, they last a lot longer time-wise. That battery chemistry, the LFP, is also considered slightly safer. So why did I choose to get the NMC version if LFP lasts longer and is safer? Well, the X2000 and the X1200 are about the same physical size, even though their capacity is so different, because LFP batteries are denser. That is, they're larger and they're heavier. The NMC battery, though, it's rated for fewer cycles, but it can store more power at one time in about the same size footprint. So the X2000 is going to allow you to be off-grid longer in a situation where there's just not a lot of sun. I've been using the X2000 for about a week, and I tend to use about 30% of the capacity overnight when there's no sun, which means I'm going through a cycle roughly every 3 days. And at that rate, it's going to take me 12 years to hit 1,500 cycles. And then it's not like you have to throw the batteries out when they reach their cycle life. They just slightly take slightly less of a full charge. The LFP version, because it has less capacity, is a little less expensive, and it might be the right choice for you if you use less power than I do, or if you have room for more units. If 1,200 watt hours, or times two if you add a B1200, if that's enough for you to have all the power you need plus some banked for a day when you have no sun, then I would say go with the X1200. Or if space is not as much of an issue for you, you could get an X1200 and multiple add-on batteries, assuming you can afford multiple add-on batteries, and that will create more capacity. I think that these products are so well made that I'm not worried about the safety angle at all on the 2000, but if you are, you have another option. You got the 1200. So now, how do you get it, and how do you get it for the best possible price? Well, for now, you can't find these on Amazon or any other retail outlet because they just launched on Indiegogo. And that is, yes, that is crowdfunding. That essentially means that you're becoming a backer of the product. And in exchange for that, you get to buy it for a very reduced price. The downside of that, of course, is that it takes longer for the company to deliver because they're using the money you're paying to actually manufacture the product. So if you need it right away, this might not work for you, but the wait will definitely be worth it. I can tell you that for sure. The sooner you pull the trigger on it and buy these, the better the price is going to be, because in crowdfunding, you get rewarded for being an early supporter. So if you get in on the super early bird price, which you can right now, it's far less than you're going to find elsewhere for what I think is a much better product. That's my opinion. So if you want them, go get them right now. There's a link in the description. Get in on that super early bird and tell them I sent you. I'll see you next time.
Get off the bus!